Why, man?
Yeah, I know. I ain't worried about that. Yes, sir.
Well, welcome back to Sacramento.
Yes, sir.
Hey, when you got here last time, you had a like kind of a big impact in the locker room and sort of the attitude and the demeanor. Is there any similarity between then and now? Have things changed?
Well, I think the organization is moving in an amazing direction as far as kind of the roster turnover. Getting Sabonis in here was huge. I had the privilege to play with Kevin Herter when he was in Atlanta. Malik Monk last year. You know, Trey Lyles had a great summer. It's so much talent. We're a very, very deep team. I think Mike Brown brings the wisdom. Being in the league for 31 years, he has kind of a bird's eye view of what it takes to win championship basketball. And I feel like he's articulating well enough to kind of cover everyone. You know, myself and Harrison being in the league this is our 11th season, and then to a guy like Keegan, who's a rookie. I think everyone's kind of buying into that. We had a very, very productive meeting last night, and we're all looking forward to it. I think the city is looking forward to it. It's been a long time coming. The collective energy of you know, the city, the organization, the player, the team, everyone involved, is we're moving in the right direction.
Do you still find yourself kind of trying to instill that sense of belief?
For sure. Yeah, because, you know, it's early in the season, and you're coming off the summer, you're feeling good, and you know, it's just something you got to sustain. You always got to keep that. It's like a pilot on the stove. You know, it's not necessarily flaming, but it's always just kind of constant there. And you got to keep that belief because it's a long season. You got, you know, the league opened it up to where 10 teams now can make the playoffs. So just focus on, you know, continuing to get better each game, each day. You know, you step on the floor, take advantage of your off time, you know, really resting and relaxing, recharging, whatever you need to do, and come back and let's go to work.
On playing defense for this squad? This is your second time around, and you know that's one of the essential things that has to happen.
Yeah, see, I think when we talk about defense in the NBA, there's a lot of misconception with how it's viewed. A lot of defense is, you know, how well the team is, you know, together, the togetherness of a team. You know, am I going to sacrifice, you know, for my teammate? Am I going to have my teammates back? If my guy get beat, am I going to be low man? If my teammate turns the ball over, am I going to sprint back and make a play for him? Those are all winning plays. I mean, championship mentality plays, next play mentality. Those are the things that we're going to have as, you know, as the Sacramento Kings this year to kind of get over the hump. I mean, I've echoed this, you know, and this is just kind of my message. You know, the more talented teams can play well for 3.5 quarters, but the last 6 minutes, the team that's together is the one that's going to prevail. And I think if we're together, you know, we can eke out, you know, 4, 5, 6 games down the stretch to really help us position ourselves in the place to really make a push when the time's right.
How different does it feel this time around than when you were here, what, 3 years ago?
I actually feel this is the best I felt personally in such a long time. I had a really, really great summer. Just kind of resetting. I took those first 10 years and kind of closed that whole chapter, you know, big, heavy novel, just poof, dust and stuff flying up. So I'm starting anew, and this is the, you know, I feel like I'm based in the same position. If you look at contract, you know, non-guaranteed, this is like my rookie year all over again, but with 10 years of experience. So for me, I've been here, and I think with my approach, I'm just going to help push everybody else, and we're all going to elevate together. But it feels great. I mean, the first time I was here, I really wanted to return, you know, because with what we had going and COVID kind of stopping all of that, you know, we had a really big game against New Orleans that night to kind of position us. I think we had a chance at the AC with like a half game back or something. So to take that away from us and then going down to the bubble with this team and spending so much time with the people in the organization, you know, you really build a bond. So, you know, I was definitely missing Sacramento. I love the feel here. I love, you know, just that the guys, they want to win. Everybody wants to win up here. The fans, see little kids running around with their Sac Proud shirts on. It feels good.
We talk about that night a lot, the night that COVID kind of shut down that game. And yep. It was in some ways like a potentially playoff preview here in Sacramento. What was the belief like going into that game, taking the floor before all the COVID stuff happened, of like, this is a big night for us and a playoff night for us?
I tell you, well, we were still out on the court. Guys were still warming up, so we were ready to go. I mean, it was the first time, well, I know since I had been here, that we really felt like we had arrived, right? Like, and you know, for everything to come to a halt like that, you're kind of still thinking about what ifs, you know. But everything happens for a reason. I think, you know, with where we are now, with, like I said, how the team's been reshaped, how, you know, the front office is a little different. I think they've repositioned themselves to make an even bigger push and kind of build off that. You know, De'Aaron going down to the bubble and having the bubble that he did, getting that experience. And, you know, like I said, bringing us a bonus. Really, really feel like we have a real chance. But it's not going to be the X's and O's for us. And we're going to keep echoing that. You know, we got to have the team chemistry off the floor and have a collective spirituality that just is greater than other teams. And regardless of the wins and losses, we can continue to build, you know, because you can't really look at, you know, the concrete stuff, especially early in the year. I mean, obviously, if you 0-16, you got issues. But, you know, you got to peel back some of those numbers sometime and just kind of look at the growth on the floor, you know, as far as, all right, this guy's making better plays. We're doing better defensively, and just keep building on the little things all year.
Building off the togetherness, is training camp and preseason enough time to establish a good team defensive identity, or do you need like in-season experience to get there?
Like I say, it's just, are we going to be together? Is each guy going to buy into the process? Obviously, it's going to be a little bit of learning curve, just understanding what we're trying to do collectively as a team on a nightly basis. Personnel changes every game. You got to play against the juggernauts of the league, like your Stephs and, you know, Kyries and Dames. You know, you got those guys that you're going to face. So, you know, obviously there's a little bit of tweaking there. But like I said, we can, you know, if every guy can buy in and play for a higher purpose, you know, I think we'll be right where we need to be when the time's right. You know, probably not a lot of people talking about us this year, but I think we're a team that's going to be really sneaky. We're going to show up every night and play really hard, and you're going to have to give us your best shot to beat us.
Baze, you've been in a lot of different situations. What determines whether a team has good accountability or not?
There's so many variables that go into that. Obviously last year, my time in L.A., you look at that roster and you're like, oh, man, like these guys are legitimate contenders, but, you know, we just lack the spirituality. I keep going back to that because it's so important. You know, this league, everyone's talented. You could probably add, with the players you have, just on the cusp of the NBA, you could probably add another two or three teams on talent. You know, so it's a deep league, but, you know, teams that lack that spirituality, I mean, you won't ever be able to get, you know, off the floor, off the surface level to really achieve and be who you want to be.
So there's a togetherness that goes into being accountable as a group?
100%. You know, my teammate gets on me, I'm not going to get defensive. I'm not going to shut down. I'm not going to disappear. You know, I'm going to take it in stride, you know, because I know he wants the best for me and we want what's best for the team. So, you know, that's just a part of you know, that, and that was kind of a lost art in the league a little bit, you know, instead of, you know, and it's hard as a man to communicate anyways. Men struggle at communicating. So we can break through those barriers and really hold each other accountable. That's when you can really start to overachieve, I think. And I really think we can do that as a team.
So talent aside, when it comes to rookies ingratiating themselves in the league, and this is a Keegan Murray question, like, well, what's the common thread you've seen of guys who have come into the league and been successful early on?
Just the willingness to accept where they are at that time. And understand that your success isn't going to be predicated on your first year in the NBA. You know, it's a long road. I was fortunate enough to be a rookie, Steph's third year in the league, and just to watch his growth from then. You know, if he would have hung all his eggs in that basket that third year in the league, like his make or break, then he wouldn't be the player who he is today. So a lot of patience comes with it. It's so much you got to learn. And, you know, Keegan being young and, you know, a rookie on his team, like I really, with the vets he has around him, and you know, kind of the talent he has around, I think he'll learn. He'll learn a lot from Trey. He'll learn a lot from Harrison Barnes. He'll learn a lot from a lot of guys. So just being patient and taking your bumps and bruises, paying your dues, and really, you know, being in it 10 toes down every day, feeling the ups and downs and what it actually feels like, and just continue to build. And you can play as long as you want. Cool.